my girl B. Simone, right? Mm-mm. You know,
it was all good just a week ago.
I don't know how you go viral twice for bags, but in 1 week, you know what I mean? B. Simone, I got your back. So, once again, B. Simone is in the news, yo.
Yeah.
So, and my girl,
and not for anything positive.
Yeah.
Unfortunately.
Yeah, my girl is out here in these streets, and she wanted to talk to you, Ashley. She wanted to talk to you personally, okay, about why she's going viral this week, y'all. Listen, y'all will let me know what you think in the comments about my girl, B. Simone, okay? And we'll tell y'all the story of what happened, okay?
Go ahead.
Surrounding my book, but because it's now a legal matter, I can only say so much. But
we know what you're gonna say.
Don't say anything at all.
You did it.
I had to create a book for young women to change their mindset and to manifest.
Yes, manifest.
Hey, man.
Be someone talking about manifesting.
That's what I know about.
So bad intention. Start with good intention.
Manifestation.
My story, right?
That's what she knows.
I've never been an author, so
we know that.
She ain't never been an author.
That don't excuse you to write the book. She knows it's her book.
They did a lot of things without my knowledge.
A lot of things.
Stop it.
Hey, man, I was listening to my girl B. Simone, man.
Yeah.
All right, so guys, just to fill you in, you listen to this on a podcast in the future. My girl B. Simone went viral last week in the last episode. You didn't watch it. Watch last week's episode and catch up. Episode 7. But yeah. My girl B. Simone, man, last week said she wasn't dating no 9-to-5 dudes.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. And within the same week, B. Simone, now I saw on Twitter she was trending because her book, Manifest the Dreams, or something you want.
Yes. It was also that you didn't see it was manifest and then also copy and paste. That's what it was.
Right.
It was manifest. They were going in between titles, manifest or copy and paste.
So a young lady came out and said that B. Simone plagiarized her.
She came with the facts. She came with the proof. She said, yo, B. Simone didn't even change the font. You didn't even change the font.
Be like, Simone, I just need to know, was it Times New Roman? You know what I'm saying? Was it Times New Roman?
Yo. That's why you use on those papers to give you an extra page and a half of Times New Roman. That's what you were doing.
Yes. Hey, that's the college trick. Look, Be Simone, I'm a C student. I understand, right? I learned not to plagiarize. All you got to do is take one or two sentences out of the paragraph. Come on, y'all. C students, what's up? One or two sentences out each paragraph, all right?
She didn't even try to summarize or use her own words. She just said, nah, that's good enough. Okay, well, that'll do. That's what she said. And I'm just like, come on now. You can't say, hey, I'm just trying to write this book for empowerment. And that's cool. Then write the book. You gotta understand. Some of these things take work and people get paid for this. And when you take stuff from this, from these people who put in work, then that is a legal matter. My thing is this is where I got scared. I'm gonna be real with you, because I was like, yo, people came to her defense. And I'm like, wait a minute, where's the accountability for here? Because copy and paste and obviously taking other people's work. And people know that, you know what I'm saying? That's common sense. Now, if you're going to say, hey, people did stuff without my knowledge, then, yo, you didn't write the book. You had people writing the book. You put your name on it. And that's cool. But you got to understand that you basically co-signed the book. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You ain't write a book. You co-signed a book. Or you co-wrote. I don't even say co-wrote. Because if you don't know what's going on, then it's your business.
She said, look. Hey, Ashford, quit being so hard on my girl. Be some mine. Okay, she said that, look, she never wrote a book before. But what she wanted to do is manifest a book. Okay? And the best way to manifest a book, if you in college,
I know...
Right. Now, look, I know when you was at Howard, please tell us how Oh, I'm sorry. Please tell us how you was copying and pasting, you know, in a couple of those classes. We just want to know.
Excuse me, what? About a couple of things. They still on me, like, Ash, we need to ask you about this. This ain't looking too right. I don't know what you're talking about, Mr. Long. I have no idea.
I'm sorry. I'm not snitching. I'm not going to Tekashi you.
but
I'm not going to 6ix9ine, man.
Well, sometimes when you talking about some scientific stuff that you never go use in your life, some theories. Theories are literally whatever you can pull out your ass. That's what theory is. It's theories, you know what I'm saying? So you reciting everybody's theories and all that stuff, man. So I'm not getting paid from it.
Oh my God. Anyway, if you're writing a book, all I gotta say is, just go to the dark web. There are people that write, that can write. You can just pay for a book that's no one used in a couple of years. I'm just saying, there's ways.